So the original store was down here on Lower Monroe, about where the exit is, the north exit is from the city county parking ramp, because the Crescent Street came all the way down there, and Monroe was then called Canal back in the 1870s. So Canal and Crescent was where Wurzburg's began its life. And particularly at Christmas time, one of his principal rules was his worker bees, when they showed up in the morning, had to go out and sweep the sidewalk clean. In 1950, the Herpelsheimer family, another German family of entrepreneurs in general goods, built the new building, which is now, of course, the Cop House, up at the front of Monroe and Fulton. And they sold their eight-story building, which is now where the art museum is, to the Wurzburg Company. And I was there when we broke the ribbon.
My very first memory, actually, is when we moved to Grand Rapids. And we moved to the south end on Morris and Wealthy. And we used to actually walk. Me and my brother used to get all dressed up, get our boots on and our hats and our gloves. And we would walk from our house downtown to go shopping for our parents. And back then, we, of course, was Herpelsheimer's was there. And we'd stop into Herpelsheimer's, and then we would go to the, I think, to what we consider dollar stores. They were Kresge's, I think, and Woolworth's? Both of those, I think. And we would go and find little trinkets that we thought were just so pretty, probably a buck or 50 cents or whatever. And we'd come home and we'd wrap them up. Back then, we could just walk all downtown, get a little candy, and come back home and wrap our gifts.
I worked for delivering packages for Herpelsheimer's from 1947 to 1989. Oh, I used to deliver gifts for Herpelsheimer's, you know. And it was great to see the little kids, you know, they'd come, you know, and you'd see all these presents, you know, and they was all wrapped up, you know. And, but, you know, I enjoyed it very much. And it was a great job. They used to decorate the window, I mean, the streets, you know, with every, so like, telephone wire or whatever it was, you know, they put it all across there, you know, and it really was interesting, you know, it was beautiful, yeah, and there was always one that's a snow, you know, everybody had hope for snow. Well, years ago, we did have some pretty good storms.
Memories of downtown Grand Rapids is coming downtown as a little kid. It was a big deal when we got to come to downtown Grand Rapids and walk around the streets and look in all the shop windows. Now I have a very distinct memory of being probably 5 or 6 years old, going to Herpelsheimer's and climbing on the little train that hung from the ceiling. And it was so scary, but it was so cool. Up, I had the privilege of being on the Steckity's teen board, and one of the things that we came up with as a board is being live mannequins in the windows during the holidays. So that's right, we would put on all the gear and go stand and freeze in the window, and then when little kids were watching, we'd come to life. It was so fun, and I actually think I was rocking a pair of Dango cowboy boots, and it was amazing.
Well, it was always a warm and friendly time for us. And I love shopping downtown for Christmas, and I love the parades that we would have. And
we all went to parades all the time, every Christmas.
But Christmas at Wurzburg was very, very special. In downtown Grand Rapids was the retail center of the region at that point. We had three major department stores: Steckity's, which was Dutch, Wurzburg, which was German, and Herbolsheimer's, which was German. And there was competition between the Herbolsheimer's and the Wurzburg. My pride says we always won, to outdo each other at Christmas time. So the decorations in the building were absolutely staggering. I mean, it would have been, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars today, but they just did it themselves. And they had big, big show windows, both Herbolsheimer's and even Steckity, to show their wares out the front. And they had moving creatures and power that you didn't see, and they spent just tons of money on those wonderful windows.
But they had the windows decorated really nice, and it was really good. Of course, Herps and Wurzburgs at that time were competition to each other, you know, and they all tried to each outdo each other, you know, in the window displays. And it was always a constant battle for them. People did the work, you know, in the windows to, you know, try to outdo the other store. I worked there 42 years and I loved every moment of it.
And you can mix, you know, if you choose to be creative in your shopping. I mean, you can mix shopping with libating and revelry and dining and exercise, and do so within a, you know, few block area. One of the things I love about this community is that we are so house proud. We love our city. I mean, this is my favorite city in the world. You couldn't drag me out of here. I love Grand Rapids. I love Michigan. And it is so rewarding to me to be participating in the rebirth of this city.
And it's still a town, you know, as well as a pretty big city. And I hope it always stays that way.